I'm all for saving money, but when I read that over 50% of people rely on free antivirus software to protect their PCs, I couldn't help but cringe a little bit. Why? Well, because most of them aren't using the good free antiviruses. Nope, they're stuck with outdated programs, ad-packed bloatware, or worse, antiviruses that sell your data. Don't be that person. If you're going to use a free antivirus, at least pick one that actually works. And hey, you can always game the system, try out a premium antivirus with free trials or money-back guarantees without spending a dime of your own money. Oh, and if you're ready to skip the guesswork, I've got links to some amazing discounts down in the description. But let's get right into it. So speaking of free antivirus software, is it a good idea in any situation? Well, yes and no. Here's the thing, free antiviruses are okay if you're just doing light browsing, maybe streaming a bit, and avoiding those sketchy email attachments from random Nigerian princes in need of your banking details. They're free, they offer basic protection, and they're certainly better than nothing. But, and this is a big but, the moment you're dealing with online shopping, sensitive data, or anything where security really matters, free antiviruses can fall short. Why? Well, they miss out on key features like advanced real-time protection, phishing defense, and regular updates. It's something similar to a prince in shining armor on a horse, but without the armor, without the horse, and not actually a prince. Just a regular man in a rented tuxedo. But that's where paid antiviruses come in to save the day. They're more robust, they keep up with the constantly evolving threats, and they pack in extras like VPNs, password managers, and dark web monitoring. So when should you use a free one? Well, when your risk is low. When should you pay? Well, when your peace of mind is worth more than free. Let's break it all down, starting with free antivirus. First of all, what's the catch? So here's the thing about free antivirus software. It's not all sunshine and rainbows. Sure, it's free, but free comes with a cost. First off, updates. Paid antiviruses stay on top of every new threat, ransomware, phishing schemes, sneaky Trojans, you name it, they've got you covered. Free ones, not so much. Their databases aren't always up to date, which means they might miss the latest malware lurking out there. Then there's the features, or lack of features. Real-time protection, most free options don't have it. Advanced firewalls, nope. VPNs, password managers, dark web monitoring, you can forget about it. And don't even get me started on the ads. A lot of free antiviruses love to bombard you with ads or even upsell you to their paid versions. It's like having a pushy salesperson living on your desktop. Not fun. Oh, and here's the real problem. Some free antiviruses aren't even that free. They'll collect your data, what you browse, what you click on, and sell it to advertisers. Yeah, you become the product yourself, and they're leeching your data to pay their bills. So while free antiviruses might handle the basics, they'll leave some pretty big gaps in your security. And those gaps, well, they're exactly what hackers are counting on. Okay, so let's get to the heart of it. What are your free antivirus options? Well, we've got six solid contenders here, and I'll give you a quick scoop on what they're good at and where they fall short. First up is Bitdefender Free. Now, this one's your quiet, nerdy friend who doesn't say much, but always helps you get things done. Bitdefender uses a cloud-based scanner that's super lightweight, so it won't bog down your PC while still nailing malware detection. In fact, we put Bitdefender to the test along with Malwarebytes and Windows Defender against real, live threats. As for the results, well, let's just say it held its own. Want to see the full showdown on that one? Well, check out the full test video linked down in the description after this video, because it will definitely get you thinking. Okay, but now for the downside. Bitdefender Free doesn't offer flashy extras like a VPN or a password manager. But if you're looking for reliable, no-fuss malware protection, this one's a pretty solid choice. Next, we've got Panda Free Antivirus, and let me tell you, gamers, this one's got your back. Panda's gaming mode automatically suspends notifications when you're in full screen mode, so no pop-ups will ruin your final boss fight. But it's not just for gamers. The Rescue Kit is a standout feature, and it lets you boot up an infected PC from a USB drive and clean it up. Perfect for those, I click something that I probably shouldn't have moments. We've all been there. The downside? Well, Panda's free VPN caps you at 150 megabytes a day, and that's basically just one cat video and a couple of memes, so honestly, what's that good for? Still, for solid protection and gamer-friendly features, Panda deserves a spot on this list. Now let's talk about TotalAV Free Antivirus. This one's for all the beginners out there, because it's got one of the cleanest dashboards out there. Seriously, you don't need to be a tech wizard to figure this one out. It's great at detecting and removing malware, but here's the catch. The free version doesn't include real-time protection. It's like having a mop to clean up a spill, but no one around to stop the leak in the first place. Still, if you're just starting out or need a quick cleanup tool, then TotalAV Free is another solid choice. All right, next up is Avast One Basic. This free antivirus really wants to impress. It gives you a malware scanner, a privacy advisor to help secure your online accounts, and even a VPN with 5 gigabytes of data per week. That is way more generous than most. But of course, there's a trade-off. The VPN doesn't let you choose servers, and let's just say the no logs policy is questionable at best. Plus, the interface can feel a bit cluttered, like they tried to pack everything in. That being said, if you want a free antivirus with a little extra, Avast One Basic is worth checking out. Avira Free Security is a classic go-to for a reason. It's lightweight, fast, and ridiculously easy to use. It's powered by a cloud-based malware scanner, so it doesn't hog your PC's resources, which is a huge win. Avira also comes with some handy extras like safe shopping browser extensions and some other great extras. This thing blocks trackers, phishing sites, and those annoying pop-up ads, making your browsing experience way smoother. The downside? Well, the free VPN. It's capped at 500 megabytes per month. Yeah, per month. That's barely enough to stream a single episode of your favorite TV show, especially in 4K. But if you're after reliable, no-frills malware protection with a couple of useful bonuses, then Avira gets the job done for sure. And last, but certainly not least, we have Malwarebytes Free. This one is minimalistic and straight to the point. It scans for malware and eliminates it, pretty much end of story. During our test, it caught most threats, and the browser extension blocks ads, trackers, and phishing sites. But here's the kicker, it doesn't include real-time protection. So it's best paired with something like Windows Defender if you want a decent free setup. I like to think of Malwarebytes Free as the handy backup option, the one you can call in when you suspect something's already gone wrong. It's not flashy, but it is dependable. So here's the million-dollar question. Do the benefits of free antivirus software outweigh the risks? Well, here's the blunt truth. It really depends. Free antivirus programs can absolutely handle the basics, catching common malware, blocking phishing attempts, and giving you some level of protection. For casual users, that's probably enough. But here's the kicker. The internet isn't getting any safer. Cyber threats evolve daily, and free antiviruses just don't keep up. They miss out on real-time protection, advanced firewalls, and critical features like VPNs or data breach monitoring. And those gaps? Well, again, that's where hackers, scammers, and malwares will thrive. So if you're serious about protecting your personal data, your privacy, and your peace of mind, then investing in a premium antivirus is the smarter move for sure. It's not just about avoiding risks, it's about being proactive in a world where the stakes are higher than ever and only getting higher. So while free antiviruses are certainly better than nothing, the added security, features, and updates of a paid antivirus, well, they're totally worth it in my opinion. All right, let's wrap this up. Free antiviruses, they're better than nothing. No question about it. They can handle the basics like catching malware and blocking some phishing attempts, and they're a great starting point if you're on a tight budget. But they're not perfect. Limited updates, missing features like real-time protection, and in some cases, questionable privacy practices mean that they do leave gaps in your security. And let's be honest, cyber threats aren't slowing down anytime soon. So here's the takeaway. If you're just browsing, streaming, or doing low-risk stuff online, a free antivirus might be enough for now. But if you're shopping, handling sensitive data, or just want real peace of mind, a paid antivirus is definitely the way to go. Think of it as an investment in your online safety. But now it's your turn. If you have any of these free antiviruses, what's your experience like? Let us know down in the comment section below. I'd love to hear your thoughts on any of the antiviruses that you're currently using. And hey, while you're down there, don't forget to check out our other videos for more tips and reviews. And hit the like button, subscribe, and of course, I'll see you in the next video. Stay safe out there.